Taoiseach, on the 19th of December last year, you rammed through the legislation that would create Irish Water. The opposition refused to take part in what was a charade, and we walked out in protest. One of the microphones was left on that day, and it picked up a government deputy saying, "Let them go," with an expletive in the middle. It shows the kind of contempt that this majority government holds to those with opposing views. You needed to ram through that legislation in order to proceed to transfer 11 billion euros worth of assets from county and city councils to Irish Water by the 1st of January. Taoiseach, there are two things that Irish people hate. One is they hate being bullied, and they hate being taken for fools. And both this government and Irish Water have managed to do both. The process of having to hand over your PPS number makes people feel bullied. The idea that if people don't hand it over, they'll be fined infuriates people. People feel that they've been taken for fools. And there's been too many examples of it. The partnering with Bord Gáis that was supposed to produce huge savings when it was actually massive start-up costs. It also brought about a bonus culture that people are sick and tired of listening to the propaganda about. The controversial awarding of the metering contract and almost all other facets of Irish Water, none of which sit well with people. The way this has been approached has alienated people who believe conservation fixing leaky pipes is important, including myself. Alienated people who have data protection concerns. Alienated people who are really pretty much terrified about the uncertainty and the extent of the growing number of charges. And alienated people who are fearful that this government and Irish Water are making it up as they go along. And my questions are, Taoiseach, the government are hell-bent on giving the impression that the entire failure is a communications and Irish Water board failure, when in fact it's a far more substantial failure than that. It's a total loss of trust in government. And we're now at the blame game. And what blame do you place on yourself for the loss of trust that this whole omni-shambles that is Irish Water?
Thank you.
What possible difference can the extension of a month make? And do you think that the events of the 19th of December 2013 will ultimately determine the results of the next general election?
Thank you.
Well, the answer to your last question is that the people will decide the next general election, and they'll make their choices whenever that's called. And the intention is that that should be in the spring of 2016. And that's always where that it should be. The people are the masters, and the people whom they elect here are merely their servants. In regard to Irish Water, I've dealt with this at length yesterday, Deputy Murphy. The reasons are well known why it's necessary to set up Irish Water, to have a public entity enshrined in law, which can borrow off the balance sheet for proper investment in infrastructure, in high quality water, in treatment plants, so that from drinking water to supplies for business and for industry, that investment can actually take place. I dealt with the question of the unitary board between Arvia, the former Bord Gáis, and Irish Water, which will take place by the 1st of November. At the end of November, and obviously board have a particular function themselves. I don't want to interfere in any way with the regulator here, who made some comments yesterday at the Oireachtas committee, and obviously we'll follow through with whatever the regulator decides in his with his independent responsibility. It is more than communications, Deputy Murphy. This is one of the largest institutions to be created, and necessary that it be so. And obviously there are challenges in the time scale that has been set out here. Most of the complaints that I've had myself are about the, if you like, the mechanics of how Irish Water deal with telephone calls, with queries, with emails, with requirements to fix leaks, and questions that they have around water supplies or treatment work supplies, and all of that. Clearly the issues that government reflected on yesterday are being discussed between Irish Water with the department, and the regulator has got his own independent responsibilities. I do hope that, arising from those discussions, that we can have clarity and understanding, that people can have confidence in Irish Water, that they will know what it is that they get for the contributions that they make here, in terms of improvement of plants, improvement of infrastructure, an ending to boiled water notices, and a system of a provision of water for people that is of the highest integrity and the highest standard. This is necessary for the next decades hence. It's never been dealt with, and I know it's challenging and it's not easy. And the question of it being as fair and as affordable for everybody is where we need to be. So I do hope that over the next period now we can have clarity and confidence for everybody, so that they can know that the contribution they make is for the very important purpose of investment, raising of standards, quality of water, so that we can deal with from personal provision to business and industry alike for many decades to come.
Thank you.
It's not an easy thing to get an institution like this running as efficiently as one would like. And clearly there have been challenges and are challenges, and I hope we can deal with those.
Deputy Murphy, 1 minute, thank you.
Taoiseach, I don't know who you're listening to if you think that this is just a communications issue or, you know, teething problems with setting up a utility. It's far more fundamental than that. And the way it's been handled has been an absolute disgrace and has caused a great upset to people. The 100,000 people on the street were not complaining about the phone not being answered to them. And, you know, the impression is being given that we're starting from scratch. The example was given that it's on a par with setting up the electrification of the country, when in fact, as I said in my remarks, 11 billion of assets, some of them first world assets, many of them first world assets that have been invested in decades, over decades, were handed over to Irish Water. Taoiseach, this is far more important than the communications issue. This is a loss of trust in how government have handled this issue, from ramming the legislation through to creating a piece of legislation or adding Irish Water to the list of organisations that people can are required to hand their PPS numbers over to, so as that you could circumvent data protection rules, and that's what the Data Protection Commissioner says. So Taoiseach, I'll repeat my question. You know, in this blame game, where do you place yourself in this blame game that is now focused on the board of Irish Water, where in actual fact it's a political failure?
Well, obviously, as head of government, the government made the decision to set up Irish Water. It was the right decision to make. The government made the decision to not have every different local authority with a different standard of provision of water and the difficulties that they all encountered. And that's the right decision. For instance, the regime that's in place at the moment with the regulator, whereby the bills are capped at 278 for a couple with two children, but also that if the user or the consumer, if the bill is actually less than that, that there's an incentive for them to have the opportunity to pay that lesser bill. Now, the regulator will make his comments about that in due course. I think it's important to say, Deputy Murphy, that Irish Water, as I said yesterday, have not done themselves justice in pointing out what it is that they are doing in terms of their own capital programme of 1.2 billion to deal with 126 treatment works that are not up to standard, and the same across many of the other areas of the country. This is a public entity. Fears that this is going to be privatised or sold are grossly are wrong, are unfounded, and without base. It's the law. This is a provision of a public entity to invest in infrastructure so that people can have high standards of production, good quality water, monitored by the regulator, who's already said, I want a reduction in your cost base by 8% by the end of 2016, including a substantial amount in respect of pay and salaries in there. So this is a case, clearly, where there are challenges still ahead, and we hope to deal with those clearly so that people can have confidence that this is a necessary facility, that the contribution they make is going for what it's intended. Investment in infrastructure, production of high quality water, treatment works that stand up to scrutiny, and that people can have a service, not like in this city where things can go wrong and they're on a knife edge all the time, for very many decades to come. And I hope we can deal with all those in the short period ahead.
Thank you. That completes